Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this section of Undecidability, we will be discussing the part 2, that is the examples of recursive languages and recursive enumerable languages. In the previous video, we have discussed about the countable and uncountable sets, and now we will discuss the examples of recursive languages and RELs. So let's get started friends. First of all, the examples of recursive languages are emptiness problem of DFA. That is whether it accepts an empty language or not. That second one is finiteness problem of DFA, whether it accepts finite language or infinite language. That third point is membership problem of DFA, whether a particular string belongs to a DFA or not. And fourth one is equivalence problem of DFA. So all these are recursive languages. Now the next examples of recursive languages are emptiness problem of CFG, context-free grammars, finiteness problem of CFG, membership problem of CFG. Note that the equivalence problem of CFG is not recursive language. Okay, now heading towards next examples. Next example is that checking whether a finite automata accepts complete language or not, or totality problem. Next one is checking whether Turing machine enters into a state queue or not within 100 steps. Note that within 100 steps it is written, that is within finite steps we can determine whether the Turing machine enters into state queue or not is the recursive language. Now checking whether Turing machine having 100 states or not. So this is also, we are given that it contains some finite arbitrary number, that is we are given here 100, it may be 1200, anything you can write, that is checking whether Turing machine having 100 states or not. It is a recursive language. Now the next example is that checking whether given string is member of given Turing machine or not within 2016 steps. It may be any finite number, a random number we have given 2016, it may be 2017 and so on. Okay. Anything, that is you can write is 20,000, finite number should be given. Okay, so note that we are giving some finite conditions with the last three examples, so that has to be noted down. Now we are heading towards the recursive enumerable language, but not recursive languages. These are the examples. First of all, ambiguity language. Second, membership problem of Turing machine. That is checking whether string X is accepted by a given Turing machine or not. It is a recursive enumerable but not recursive language. Third one is that checking whether a Turing machine enters a state queue or not. Note that in the previous examples we have written that checking whether a Turing machine enters into a state queue or not within 100 steps. So if it is written within 100 steps, that we can determine in finite number steps, so it will be recursive. But here it is not given that any condition is not given. Directly we have written that checking whether Turing machine enters into state queue or not. So this is recursive enumerable but not recursive language. Heading toward the fourth example, checking whether language generated by a given Turing machine is regular or not. That is regularity problem. It is recursive enumerable but not recursive language. Now fifth point is that checking whether Turing machine accepts epsilon or not. It is REL but not recursive language. Now heading towards non-recursive enumerable languages. Non-recursive enumerable languages are uncountable sets that we have discussed in the previous video that are undecidable. Now second one is that set of all unambiguous grammars. Third one is complement of recursive enumerable but not recursive language. So note that complement of recursive enumerable but not recursive languages. Okay. So these are non-RELs. So you have to note that the complement of recursive enumerable but not recursive language is non-recursive enumerable language. One point you should also keep in mind that the complement of a recursive language is recursive language only. But complement of recursive enumerable but not recursive is non-recursive enumerable languages. So that is important, and question comes here from here also. And now next point is that checking whether two CFGs generate same language or not, that is equivalence problem of CFG, that I've already told in the recursive that it was not there, the equivalence problem of CFG was not there in recursive. It is here in non-recursive enumerable language. It is checking whether two CFGs generate same language or not. It is also known as the equivalence problem is a non-recursive enumerable language. I think towards next example is that checking whether given CFG generates complete language or not, or totality problem of CFG is non-recursive enumerable language. Now next point is that equivalence problem of Turing machine is also non-recursive enumerable language. Next point is checking whether Turing machine accepts complete language or not. That is, totality problem of Turing machine is also non-recursive enumerable language. Next one is emptiness problem of Turing machine. This is also non-REL, that is non-recursive enumerable language. So friends, that is all for the examples of recursive, non-recursive and recursive enumerable but not recursive languages. I hope everything is crystal clear. If any doubts, please comment on the below of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. So please like, comment and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you.